What the hell is up, comic book lovers, toy collectors, nerds, geeks, awesome people? Welcome to another comic book haul. This is going to be the comic book haul from October 18th, 2015. Now, October 18th is actually a very special date. It's my sister's birthday! Yay! So, right now, instead of spending time with my sister, I am currently recording this video. It's okay because she's watching football. She's watching the Packers. I believe they're winning. Good thing because she loves the Packers. Anyway, just in case my sister is watching this video later, happy birthday, sis. I love you. And I am glad to be on this comic book collecting, Funko Pop collecting, toy collecting journey with you. This nerdy journey that keeps us young. So, gotta take a drink for my sister. Cheers. And there we go. Actually, I better finish that because I don't want it to be hot. Okay. This is gonna be a big one. We have... excuse me. I have a lot to show off today. A lot. Good comic book haul. Lots of new toys and goodies. So, to be honest, I don't even know where to start. So, as always, big shout out to Bagging Board Comics in Whittier, California. And Undercity Comics, also in Whittier, California. But we did get a couple of comics from Midtown Comics in New York. No, we didn't go to New York. We special ordered them. My toothache is getting worse and I refuse to go to the dentist. What an idiot. And yeah, like I said, we got a lot of toys to show off, so let me go ahead and get started. The first two comics that we got were special orders from Midtown Comics. We got them during the week, so it's not part of this haul, but I am going to show them off because I'm not going to make a separate video just for these. I normally would if we had a big order, but we didn't. So like I said, we got these from Midtown Comics, and they are actually the same comic. One is the standard, one is the variant, and that is for this awesome character. Agent Melinda May from S.H.I.E.L.D., Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. to be more specific, the TV series, aka the Cavalry. Now, if you watch Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you know that she is played by Nina Wen, who is just simply gorgeous and whose beauty defies all age. But anyway, she's an awesome character. So first of all, let me show you the cover art. There you go. 50 Years of S.H.I.E.L.D. I believe this is the last one. The last 50 Years of S.H.I.E.L.D. Comic. There you go. Don't call her the Cavalry. And here is the very cool, very sexy variant. Now, my sister and I, we love this character. We freaking love her in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I love Nina Wen. She's sexy as hell. And then you happen to get this. I came across this, I forget how. I was actually reading a Secret Wars comic, and it was one that I was catching up on. So, you know, you look at the ads and sometimes you see old stuff. And, I saw that they were advertising all the 50 Years of S.H.I.E.L.D. comics. And, you know, as you already know, if you watch my haul videos, I got all of the other ones. But then I saw this and I'm like, wait a minute, I never saw that. So, when we went to the comic shop a couple of weeks ago, they didn't have it. I was stressing out. My sister says, okay, I'll order them from Midtown Comics, and there you go. Now I got these. I believe this series is complete. Very happy, and I can't wait to actually read this because I love this character, and I can just imagine what they put in this comic book. She actually needs her own comic book, a running series of Agent Melinda May. She's awesome. Alright, so that is it for Midtown, obviously, just two comics. But I am going to now show you, I'm going to go with Undercity first, because I got a lot of great stuff on Begging Board. I got some good stuff on Undercity, but I want to hold off on Begging Board for a second. Ow. Okay, so, here it is. Here's the ironic thing. We got another Gotham bag. I have so many of these bags, it's ridiculous. Oh yeah, and this stupid show, Minority Report, that's gonna be canceled soon. So first, let's go ahead and show off what we got from Undercity. I don't really have them in any particular order, so I'm gonna save this one. Let's go ahead and show this one first. I could have sworn, I don't know, I feel like I have this already. But it was in the news section, they had a bunch of copies, so it's almost like, I haven't seen this in a few weeks, so this pops up, it has to be new. So I really don't know, if it's an extra copy, whatever, but anyway, we have issue number 4, Marvel Zombies, Part of the Battle World, Secret Wars series. Very cool cover. This is a series that I did not care for when I first started it, but then I believe season 2 they had a really cool cameo that I liked, and then I read issue number 3, which was really interesting and really like intense, and the characters have come a long way, so it's a pretty good series, and I'm very sure I don't have this one. So issue number 4 of Marvel Zombies. I'm gonna put them in the bag as I go, because I don't want them scattered all over the place. Next we have issue number 4, once again, part of Secret Wars. We have A-Force. Awesome cover right there. I'm pretty sure this is the final issue. So, that is a great cover. If this is the final issue, that definitely looks like a great way to go out. So, can't wait to read this series. Like I said, you know, there's a lot of these comics that I'm just collecting right now. One day I'm just gonna seal myself off, forget the rest of the world, and just read. I read little by little, but I haven't started on this. By the way, I finished Old Man Logan. I read the last issue. That was pretty good. It's more of an emotional drama than it is an action comic, but that was pretty cool. I'm looking forward to when they actually start the new series. So anyway, I'm done with that one. Is that it for Marvel? Yeah, okay. Well, there's one more Marvel, but I'll show you that last. Next is issue number 4 of Image Comics, The Covenant. This is something that my sister reads. She really enjoys it. I should probably read it too. I mean, it's sword and sandals, so it's right up my alley. I love that stuff. So anyway, Covenant number 4. And I can't get it in the bag. There we go. Next is one that I have this thing. If I see a comic, it's an issue number 1, and it looks interesting, it catches my eye, might as well pick it up and give it a shot. So for this, we got something from Dark Horse Comics. I've been wanting to get more Dark Horse Comics. So anyway, we have issue number 1 of Eve Valkyrie. No idea what this is about, no idea whatsoever, but it's Dark Horse. Brian Wood, I've seen that name before, so, you know, and it looks pretty cool. It looks like something I might enjoy. It's a female character, and, you know, you know how I am with female characters. I love ass-kicking women, so hopefully there's something within that vein. At least that better be a chick, unless it's a very slender dude. But, anyway, we'll see how this goes. If you've read this one or checked it out, let me know what you think. Alright, so now we got a bunch of DC stuff. Good DC comics here. I had to have this. I don't collect Harley Quinn, but this is awesome. I don't know if it's a variant. I don't think so. But I had to have this because when you see it, you'll know. You'll know what it's paying homage to. And that is issue number 21 of Harley Quinn. But look at that. Look at that. It's so obvious what it's, imitating. Obviously on the, wow, she got blood on the axe and everything. That is awesome. Hey, Deadshot, here's Harley. That's awesome. So obviously, if you're not a film buff of any kind, then you don't know that this is The Shining, starring Jack Nicholson. The famous Here's Johnny line, this is what that is. If you don't know that, I don't know you. Who are you? So anyway, awesome cover. I had to have it. I'm not going to read it, but I had to have this. Alright, so next we have... yes, I do collect this one. issue 25 of Batman Superman Injustice. So, I so want to read this, but I'm missing issues. I have to find the issues that I don't have, that way I can have it all, and I just can't wait to read this, but, maybe I'll look up to see what issue is a good, starting point, and, maybe I'll start reading this, because I really want to read this. Next is, this is what my sister collects. I didn't even know they were still making these. Anyway, we got Bombshells, and this is issue number 3. So, pretty cool. Something that she reads. I'm not gonna read it, but if she enjoys it, why not? And it's got some very nice artwork. Okay, this is cool. I heard about this series. It looks like it's gonna be a weekly series, so I don't know if it's gonna be any good. I really wanted to get Batman Eternal, but by the time I discovered it, it was way into its, into its run. And even though I found a lot of the back issues, they always had them in the stores, could never find issue number 1. So I just let it go, and I figured, okay, I'll let that come out with trades, and I'll look at it that way. But this, I was hoping to find. Last week, I didn't even think about it. I didn't even see this until this week. So anyway, we have issue number 1 of Batman and Robin Eternal. So, I don't know if it's going to be any good. It's got some really good cover art. And, it looks badass. So I hope that it's good. I'm going to check it out. And you'll see that I actually have issue number 2. Spoiler. I got that, later to show you. So I'm glad I found this, because I got number 2 just in case I would find it, and I found this, so I'm happy. Okay, so next we have issue 45 of Batman. 45. Somebody just turned 45. That's my sister. But that's okay. That's okay. That's a good age. It's my favorite caliber pistol. So, this looks pretty awesome. Can't wait to read it. But I have some catching up to do. So, Batman 45. You got it. Anytime you can come out of a comic shop with a Batman comic, yay. Take a little drink. It'll shut this up. And that's gone. Okay. Next is a variant. I can't believe they're still doing these Green Lantern variants, but anyway, issue number 4 of Justice League of America. That is cool. I like this. Even if I wasn't collecting this, or, she wasn't collecting this series, I would get this cover. This is just really badass. Looks all heroic and shit. So, check that out. sexy. And that, of course, is to commemorate the 75 years of Green Lantern. Now, finally, from Undercity, we got a big haul from Undercity. This, I was pretty excited about. When I first heard about it, I was like, no way. What the hell is the character going to say? It's a character that doesn't really speak English or any language that a human would understand, or us humans would understand. Certain human characters in a different galaxy understand this character. And I'm thinking, how the hell are you going to make a comic book of Chewbacca? Really? That's how you're going to read it. But it got me thinking. It's like, Chewbacca's a hell of a warrior. He's obviously had plenty of adventures, even before he met Han Solo. So why not? And you do have a character that will speak English, that we can read. So, okay. Why not? Give it a shot. I like Chewbacca, and I hope this is a good one. So, issue number one of Chewbacca. Very excited. What I'm not happy about is I am missing Darth Vader number 10. That came out last week, and by Undercity, they're usually really good at pulling all the Star Wars comics for me. They didn't have it. Shame. So now I'm going to have to order that. I'm going to have to order that, and that's okay, because I still have to order Lando number 3. Ugh, that's killing me. So next week, I'm going to show off Bagging Boards Haul. Lots of good stuff. I probably should make a separate video for the toys, but I'm not gonna. Not gonna do it. So just stay with me. Turn off the video now, watch it in parts, whatever. I'm not gonna make a separate video. Okay, we are gonna save these. Save those for later. Let's go ahead and show off what we got from Bagging Board. Which, JC, if you're watching this video, I doubt it. You are the man. I'm glad we saw you today. Anyway, let's go ahead and show off the DC stuff. So, I just showed you Batman and Robin Eternal. That was number one. Here's number two. So, Robin looks younger here. So, I wonder if this is a series that, like, goes in chronological order, or if it has, like, flashbacks. I don't know. Anyway, here's issue number two of Batman and Robin Eternal. Okay, that's pretty cool. Shit, I don't know where to put this stuff. I'm just gonna drop it on the floor. Next is issue number one. My sister was really excited for this. I don't know if it's gonna be any good, but wow, Superman does have a cool beard. Anyway, we have issue number one, Superman, Lois and Clark. That is a really cool cover. That's a cool cover. Apparently, I guess that's the son of Superman. I don't know. Pretty cool. Yay, Superman and Lois and... Okay, whatever. Next, we have the standard issue of Justice League of America, issue number 4. That's great. They put out the best, you know, cover arts. The best cover art belongs to Justice League of America. They never make crappy artwork. I love it. I gotta start reading this. My sister has them somewhere stored in the garage. I gotta start reading this. It looks like such a cool series. So here's issue number 4. Is that it for DC? Okay, I guess so. So, now we move on to Marvel. And we have, this is issue number 3. That's a cool cover too. Issue number 3 of Star Wars Shattered Empire. This, of course, is part of the series that leads up to Force Awakens. These are little adventures that happened after Return of the Jedi. No, I haven't started reading it, but I like the colors. Yay, we got Lando! Moving back to Secret Wars, I guess this is the final issue. Because usually these things only go up to like 5 issues or less. I don't know, but anyway, we have Secret Wars, Civil War, issue number 5. Pretty damn snazzy. Take a close look at that. Pretty cool, right? Oh, it's a girl. I love comics. Wow, that is just awesome. Just, if you just look at it closely, you see all the characters and the details. It's just, it's gorgeous. I love it. See, look at that. Look at that. Love it. Alright, so now, part of the new Marvel series, the new era, whatever you want to call it, we have Guardians. I just created a new character. Guardians of the Galaxy issue number 1. The new Guardians. Got some interesting characters. You got, Star-Lord is looking a lot prettier these days. But yeah, really awesome. Of course, you got Rocket out in the front, taking charge. Yeah, this looks pretty cool. Pretty cool. Looking forward to that. My sister actually looked at it and was like, wow, that looks really cool. Next we have Sam Wilson as Captain America, issue number 1. Woo! I wasn't sure if I wanted to get this, but JC talked me into it. He's like, you know what, I read it, it's pretty good, they're gonna bring back Cap, the regular, Steve Rogers. So, decided to check it out. Next we have The New Avengers, issue number 1. Let's see, let's take a look at these. Okay, these are all new people, I don't know. Yeah, they're all new. This is gonna suck. Why did I get this? No, I don't know. Hopefully it's good. I'll check it out. Really trying to get not all the number ones, but, you know, the ones that intrigue me. So, hopefully this is a good one. Next we have issue number 1 of Uncanny Avengers. So we got the new Avengers, we got the Uncanny Avengers, nothing but Avengers. Avengers everywhere. So, okay, got some Deadpool, got, anyway, here you go. Oh, okay, that's it. That's it for the regular issues, but now we move on to my favorites, the hip-hop variants. I'm gonna level with you. There are a couple in here that I don't know what the paying homage to. So, first we have Uncanny Avengers, issue number 1. That's awesome. Yo, Bun Rush the Chimichangas. That's hilarious. So, obviously this is, from, Public Enemy. Was it Bun Rush the Show or something like that? I forget the name of it. But, very good Public Enemy album. And that's what that is. I like it. This is one, it's driving me crazy. Because I cannot think of what this is. I can't. It looks familiar, but I can't tell. Anyway, we have New Avengers issue number 1. I can't tell what album this is emulating. So, if anybody knows, let me know, and I'm going to feel a little stupid about it. Next, we have Sam Wilson, Captain America. And, of course, this is taken from A$AP Rocky. I don't know the name of the album, but it's A$AP Rocky. That's pretty cool. In that cover art, I believe he wraps himself in the American flag. So now you have Captain America doing the same. So that's pretty cool. Very clever. Yeah, let me show off this one. Because this is another one. I don't know what this is. I think this is something that's newer than this is a newer album, which there's a lot of new hip hop that I just don't like. So I don't know what this is, but you know, had to get them. I'm trying to get every one of these, so even if I know them or if I don't, I gotta have them. So we have Spider-Man 2099, issue number 1, and I really cannot tell what cover this is. So, I don't know. I really don't know. But if you know, let me know. And, yeah. So next we have, this is awesome. This is awesome. JC wasn't really, he couldn't really tell what this was. I had to tell him. So we have Spider-Gwen, number 1. The Great Adventures of Spider-Gwen. Which, of course, this is the album. It's taken from the album, The Great Adventures of Slick Rick. That is great. She's got the pose and everything. Just, that is a great one. I like this one a lot. Now, the one I really, really like, because this is taken from one of my favorite albums ever, and that's Guardians of the Galaxy. And of course, it's taken from The Far Side, Bizarre Ride to the Far Side. That is awesome. This is a good, I was waiting on this one. Very happy to have this one. Damn, I love it. I love it. I know my friend Liz is gonna love that because she's heavily into hip hop like I am. And this is from like when we were teenagers. That album, when it came out, wow, it changed my life. So anyway, one more look, why not? So that's it for the comics. Now let's get on to the goodies. So first, let me show you, my dad actually put these up. My dad, who's 74 years old, suddenly has this surge of Star Wars fever, which I love and I hate at the same time, because trying to describe certain things about Star Wars to an old person is a daunting task, let me tell ya. But suddenly, he wants to try to collect all kinds of Star Wars figurines, and I'm happy, but again, it's hell because he doesn't understand what he's getting. So first, we got these at Walmart, ironically. I hate Walmart, but I don't know how much you pay for these things. And I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed by these. Only because, you know, figurines, new modern figurines are not usually that good. They lack detail. But these are kind of cool. These are really cool. So we have a Stormtrooper from The Force Awakens. Pretty cool, right? I like it. I dig it. Next we have, and apparently every one of these comes with some kind of toy, some kind of like, accessory, so that's kind of cool. Next, I don't think we'll see this guy, okay, it doesn't say Force Awakens, so I don't think we're gonna see Darth Vader in Force Awakens. This is just because Darth Vader is awesome, and you have to put him. You have to give him a new figurine every time there's a new series of Star Wars toys. So anyway, here's Darth Vader. Really impressed by the detail. Yeah, this is a cool figurine. So, anytime I can get my hands on a Darth Vader figurine, I'm happy. But of course, my dad picked it up, and I'm happy about that. Because I have no money. And finally, come here, buddy, oh my god, we have Finn, how come it doesn't say his name, does it? Why doesn't it say his name? I mean, it's there, I know his name. Oh, okay, it says it back here. Oh, right there. That's kind of cheap. They put it in little text right there. Anyway, Finn, John Boyega. That's a pretty cool figurine. I'm surprised at the detail, and I'm glad they actually put him holding his gun. You know, usually the gun is off to the side and whatever. But that's pretty cool. So that's it for the Star Wars figurines. Just started showing off because they're kind of cool. Now, Funko Pops. Love getting Funko Pops. So, let me show these off because I'm not into this series. I don't watch it. I'm not going to watch it because it's too long and it's still going. Well, I think it's in its 11th season. Jesus Christ. Come on, CW. Anyway, my sister's a big Supernatural fan. Since today is her birthday, her daughter, my niece, Desiree, she brought her a couple of these. And they're kind of cute. So we got the Supernatural brothers. Forget their names. What are their names? I mean, you know, the last name. Obviously, we have Sam and Dean. So, these are cute. These are Hot Topic exclusives. And they're in their little suits. Kind of cool. Very cute. Again, I don't know nothing about Supernatural. Obviously, the actors are both sexy fuckers. Anyway, they're from my sister, and I made her very happy. Let's see. One more Funko Pop, and I have to thank JC from Dragon Board. He's just such a great guy, such a generous guy. I think we have a really good relationship with the guy. We're so close to, like, inviting him to Christmas dinner. He's that close. He's getting that close to us. He's a great freaking guy. Dragon Board Comics, go see him. You know, represent. He actually gave this to my sister. He said, it's your birthday, go out there and pick a Funko Pop. Anyone. And we were blown away. We didn't go in there wanting free stuff or a discount, but we were just talking about, you know, her birthday, you know, what we were doing for her. And he was like, go get a Funko Pop. So the one that my sister picked, I'm very glad, because we have a variation of this, but we don't have any. Let me show. It's Arrow. The one we have is, you know, Oliver without the hood. I believe he has the mask. No, he doesn't even have the mask. It's without the hood. He's in the Arrow costume, but he's not wearing the hood. He doesn't have the mask. So now we got the one with the mask. We don't usually get, you know, variants for these. We get one. For example, back there, I don't know if you can see it. You probably can't because all my cologne and everything is covering it. I got the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man from Ghostbusters. I went with the happy one instead of the mad one. I'm not going to get both. But anyway, now we got both of these. I'm very happy. I'm glad we got this because he looks awesome with the hood. So when they make a Green Arrow one, we'll get that one too. So that's it for the Funko Pop. Two more items. And oh my god, this is going to be so long. My sister bought these for herself and for us. Okay, I don't have no money. Right now, I hit kind of like a... I'm in a slump right now. But something is in the works for me to get money. But I'm going to have to wait till next year, which kind of sucks. But anyway, we saw these last week. They held them for us, and I'm very happy because these are awesome. First one, this is, I'm trying to think, where did these come from? These are the DC, obviously, DC collectibles. Yeah, they're just, they come from DC. So we have the Flash. Look at the detail on that. The detail on this is exceptional. I like it. And of course he comes with a lot of hands. It's funny because the Flash doesn't use weapons. but he has a lot of hands. Anyway, we love the detail. It's the Flash. It's awesome. We love the show. We love the actor that plays him. So, also available. Okay. So there you go, The Flash. And the last one is one that I'm very happy about. I've been wanting this for a while, and now we finally got it. And that is Deathstroke from Arrow. That is awesome. That is so freaking awesome. He's got his knives, he's got his Desert Eagle, and he's in his outfit, which is so intimidating. Dude, that is so awesome. Oh, I'm so glad we have this. So now, we have three of these. We just need the Arrow. And we'll have all of them. We'll have the whole set. But that is just exceptional right there. That is great craftsmanship. Deathstroke. Freaking love it. Love it. Okay. That is it. This video has been on long enough. But I had to show you all this good stuff. So much fun collecting this stuff. I love comics, and I'm so glad my sister and I are doing what we do. And I'm very thankful to her, because she's the one getting most of this stuff. If not, she's actually getting all of it right now until I get some money. So anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for putting up with my odd silliness. I need to go see a dentist so bad. I just don't want to. Anyway, thank you. Always read comics. Always collect toys. Collect whatever you want. If it keeps you young and happy, do it. So, thank you for watching. I'm going to go now. I'm going to read some comics and watch some shows. And just stare at these toys all day. So, yeah, not all day, but anyway, you know what I mean. Peace out.